We got interested a number of years ago in trying new places where we could test hypotheses and ask questions. And we came here and found that it's a really great place to do the kind of ecology that we want to do.
These kinds of field stations are really the observatories for global change science and sustainability science. And that's very much what we're interested in here.
Russ and I have always brought undergraduates during the summer field season with us here. And for them, it is just really life-changing, because even though they've lived away from home going to university, obviously, in a dorm or in an apartment, to come to a research station in a foreign country, for many of them, is just, often it's the first time they've traveled much outside the U.S., and coming and living here and being in this atmosphere for them is just really, really life-changing. And for some of them, it convinces them that this is what they want to do and how they want to spend their life. And for others, it convinces them that this is not how they want to spend their life. And so it's really a good experience for undergrads in thinking about careers or going to grad school or not. It can really help them make life decisions because they see this kind of atmosphere and a research atmosphere.
You know, here an undergraduate gets to actually learn that science is a process, right? It's not just something you read about. It's not just a collection of facts. That you have ideas, that you test those ideas, that you get data, that there's, you know, all kinds of intellectual and sort of logistic sort of mm-hmm. moving parts that fit together. And they do it in an environment that's very self-supportive and very willing to sort of help. And so I think the level of interest in mentorship that a student gets here is really intense. And yeah. So, you know, it's really a good experience no matter what. And they come away much more global. You know, one of the interns who came for this summer said, "Oh, I can't believe it. I get to talk to you." What do you mean you get talking? He goes, "Well, you know, you guys talk with everybody." I go, "Well, you can come to my office hours." And he goes, "That's not the same." No.
Science in the last several decades has become increasingly collaborative and interdisciplinary. And what you're seeing here now really reflects that.
Because there are lots of different scientists in different career states and lots of different disciplines, you talk to each other, you get excited about things, you learn from each other, and that's where...
Start collaborations,
and that's where all the excitement comes from. You can do bold new things, right? And that's the exciting part, is the sort of the interface between two disciplines that really haven't worked mm-hmm. much together in the past. Mm-hmm. It's pretty exciting.